Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows how to switch to dark mode in Microsoft Word for Mac. If you're on a PC, please see the Windows version of this tutorial, which will be linked below. Before we can use dark mode in Word for Mac, we first have to switch to dark mode in macOS. Once we've done that, we can switch between a dark interface with a dark page and a dark interface with a white page. We can also set our word preferences to never open in dark mode or always open in dark mode with a white or black page. To switch to dark mode in macOS, select the System Settings icon, followed by Appearance in the System Settings dialog box. From there, select Dark in the Appearance section, and then close the dialog box. After switching to dark mode in macOS, Word for Mac should automatically open in dark mode unless your word preferences are set to turn off dark mode, as we'll see in just a moment. To switch between a dark page and a white page, select the View tab, and then select Switch Modes as necessary. Before we move on, it's important to note that the dark page only changes the display on your Mac. The document won't print with a dark page or appear dark on other people's computers. If you do want to change how the page background color prints and appears to others, please see my previous tutorial, How to Change the Page Background Color in Word for Mac, which will be linked below. If you want to set Word to never use dark mode or always use it with a dark or white page background, select the Word menu, followed by Preferences from the drop-down menu. When the Word Preferences dialog box appears, select General, and then choose Turn off dark mode, Dark mode has a dark page color, or Dark mode has a white page color from the Personalize section. Note that the Turn off dark mode option here only affects Word for Mac. It won't turn off dark mode for the operating system. Lastly, close the dialog box. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlist, How to Use Word for Mac, where you'll find many related tutorials, including how to find and replace fonts in Word for Mac. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.